Hi, and welcome to Healthytarian Living. In this episode, we are going to talk all about apples and how to work with them, how to understand them, their various health and nutrition benefits, including all of the different and unique ways that we can enjoy them, and most importantly, why we want to make them a part of our regular diet. With late summer and the fall season upon us, apple season is in full swing in most parts around the world. This means we can have access to delicious, fresh, and local apples, the best way we should be eating our fruits and vegetables at any time. Many of us take apples for granted, as they are pretty much one of the most common fruits. And we may be thinking, how hard is it to work with an apple? But there are many ways that we can enjoy them, and many unique benefits that we can gain from them if we know how to use them optimally. When it comes to apple varieties, the same thing goes here. Most of us are used to just perhaps a handful or less of the various apple varieties, but according to the Apple Commission, there are over 7,500 different apple varieties worldwide. Now that's quite the number. Of course, when it comes to what we can find locally or perhaps at our grocery store, it is true that our varieties shrink tremendously. Typically, the 10 most common apple varieties are as follows: Red Delicious, Golden Delicious, Granny Smith, Gala, Macintosh, Fuji, Cortland, Honeycrisp, Empire, and Pink Lady. And each of these apples vary in color, in their flavor, and in their texture. Some are softer, some are crispier, some are sweeter, some are more tart. So there's really something out there for everyone. Like other fruits, apples offer us an incredible abundance of beneficial properties, nutrients, and health benefits. A typical apple is about 100 calories, and within those 100 calories, we can be sure that we are getting a nutrient-dense food source. Apples are predominantly composed of carbohydrates, some being a little more on the complex side, but most being ones that we would call sugars. Now, these are wholesome fruit sugars, which we do not have to fear, despite what so many of the claims out there today are trying to suggest. We have isolated, refined processed sugars to worry about and avoid, but when it comes to wholesome fruits, typically these are not one of them. Within those healthy carbohydrates that provide us with our optimal fuel and energy for our body, we are also getting about 4 to 5 grams of fiber per apple. Apples are also virtually fat-free, and about 3% of the apple's calories make up protein. Of course, one of the attributes that apples are most famous for is their vitamin and mineral composition. They are also full of beneficial phytonutrients and antioxidants, and naturally have alkalizing and anti-inflammatory properties. All of this offers powerful protection and healing for our present and future health. However, to fully appreciate the immense benefits of whole foods like apples, we have to consider the apple in the context of its whole form rather than in terms of its isolated parts. And to illustrate this perfectly, I will share with you an example of Dr. Rui Liu, who along with his research team beautifully discovered the value of whole foods versus their isolated nutrients and parts. Their findings were published in the Journal of Nature in June 2000. And basically, it goes like this. When they tested the vitamin C in 100 grams of apples, in its isolated form, it comprised about 5.7 milligrams. Not much to rave about. However, when they examined the apple as a whole, they found over 1,500 milligrams of antioxidant-like vitamin C activity. Now that is a tremendous difference. So imagine if we are looking at a nutrition facts label about apples, we might see under the vitamin C about 8% of our daily value. But see, this is a perfect example how when we isolate the different food parts and try to examine them separately, we are not getting the full picture about the power of our food. It would be a very different story if we examined and understood the food as a whole. And so aside from these types of benefits, as part of their research findings, they also concluded that whole foods like apples appear to be more effective than isolated antioxidant supplements, especially when it comes to healing or prevention against something like cancer. And so this is also a great example that we can use on a practical basis. The next time perhaps you feel a cold coming on, instead of reaching for that synthetic vitamin C, reach instead for a fresh, whole apple. But it's not just when it comes to our immune system that apples ultimately have so many different health benefits. They benefit our digestive system, optimize our elimination, detoxification, cleansing, like all fruits. They also optimize the function of all of our cells, providing optimal nutrients to every part of our body that depends on it. And so it is definitely in our best interest for present and future health, as well as our weight, to consume fruits like apples on a regular basis. Now, how should we be eating our apples? You might think, again, this is such an easy thing to tackle. After all, it's one of the first fruits we are given as children. When it comes to consuming apples, the first place to start is to make sure that your apple is fresh and you are consuming it in its whole and raw form. This is how we can get the most benefits when it comes to all those beautiful nutrients and health benefits from our apples, rather than denaturing or deactivating, or plainly put, destroying so many of those valuable compounds. Let's just take vitamin C as an example. According to laboratory tests, at 70 degrees Celsius, which is about 160 degrees Fahrenheit, vitamin C is denatured. This means that we don't want to be boiling our apples or baking our apples. These are very low temperatures within which we can contain and maintain that vital vitamin C, as well as all of the beneficial antioxidant activity and other phytonutrients, many of which are also highly sensitive to heat. And so the less we process our fresh fruit, like apples, the better, the more we actually get out of them. This means that if we are serious about our health, we specifically want to avoid apples in the two most common processed forms that most people consume them in: processed or baked apple pies and processed pasteurized apple juice. Both of these pretty much offer us no nutritional or health value as what the apple is capable of. Not only that, but they also introduce and usually come along with other undesirable factors for our health and our weight. So if you are serious about your health and weight, you are avoiding all of the different processed, refined, and pasteurized apple-like, apple-including, or apple-flavored products, as they do not come close to what a whole natural fruit is all about. Another tip for consuming your apples in the most optimal of way is be sure to eat them when they're seasonal. There's no need to eat apples in March when they are pretty much out of season. And so this is how we can optimize the immense variety of the different fruits out there. Consume them when they are fresh and seasonal. And also, when it comes to apples, it is very important to make sure that we are only choosing and consuming organic apples, especially important if you have little ones around. As according to the EWG Environmental Working Group's annual pesticide report, apples continue to be one of the worst foods, fruits specifically, that contain high levels of pesticide residues on them. And so while it's easy to find apples in any grocery store pretty much worldwide, it's not easy to find organic apples, never mind local and fresh organic apples. So if you find such a source, definitely take advantage of it. You can also check if you have any wild apples growing in your area. Most people abandon wild apple trees thinking that they are just useless, but they can provide some of the tastiest, most natural apples possible. Another tip here is, if you have even a little bit of land suitable to plant a tree, invest in your own apple tree. It's one of the best investments that we can do for ourselves, our garden, and our health. Buying a small apple tree at your local home hardware or nursery, within about 3 to 5 years, you can start enjoying your own natural, fresh, local, and organic apples. When it comes to enjoying whole, fresh, natural apples, many people also wonder, what about the seeds? Most of us have heard that apple seeds contain a cyanide compound. So what's the story here? Well, while it is true that yes, apple seeds do contain a cyanide compound, most people over-embellish the danger of apple seeds. Apple seeds have a very thick, hard coat protecting them. It would take an incredible amount of apple seeds that would also have to be crushed or masticated or broken down to actually cause us any kind of harm. And so in the event that we may swallow one or two, they will typically pass through our digestive system untouched, and so cause us no harm. But in the event that we do bite into or chew an apple seed, or include some perhaps when we are juicing and didn't cut out the core completely, this is still okay, as our body is actually capable of detoxifying small amounts of cyanide. So the biggest precaution here is obviously make sure that your children are not consuming apple seeds or specifically chewing on apple seeds. But in general, when it comes to us as adults, there's no need to fret or panic if you do chew into or consume the odd apple seed. Plus, as we've learned from other seeds or pits, for example, like apricots, what may seem as dangerous or toxic to the mainstream is actually turning out to be highly healing and medicinal under the right circumstances. So we always have to remember that there are no mistakes in nature. Nature is not out to get us. There is a purpose for everything. But it is up to us to learn about the purpose and to use it in the best of ways as needs dictate. So finally, let's get practical. What do we do with our apples? Well, the first place to start, once you've acquired your hopefully fresh, local, organic, and seasonal apples, is to wash them. After that, you don't have to do much else, and definitely not peel it, as the peel contains so many of the beneficial nutrients as well as properties for the health benefits that we talked about. There's one exception. If you absolutely want to have an apple, but you cannot find an organic one, then in the case of conventional apples, it may actually be in your best interest, especially for kids, to peel the apple. And at that point, we can simply consume the apple as is whole, biting it right to the center, and then throwing away the core, hopefully into a composter. However, another practical way to eat the apple is to quarter it or cut it into slices. You would start by cutting the apple down lengthwise in half and then cutting those two halves into quarters or further into slices as you may desire. You can eat the apple in this form, and it's best actually for young kids who have smaller mouths, perhaps still some of their teeth are coming in. And you can eat the apple as is on its own with all of its beautiful, juicy, and delicious flavors, or you can pair it with something like a wholesome, natural raw nut or seed butter. If you cut the apple widthwise, you can get a lovely star pattern for decoration purposes. If you remove the core first, however, this is also the way that you can get or make apple rings, whether this is for fresh purposes or for dehydrating purposes. Aside from eating the apple on its own as a snack, you can also add apples to various meals. However, like all fruits, we want to make sure that we only add fruits to very simple meals. For best digestion, we really don't want to or shouldn't be eating our apples or any fruits for that matter after meals, especially heavy, dense meals and all sorts of ingredients, especially if you are consuming any animal products. So you can make beautiful, cooked, wholesome grain bowls, such as steel-cut oats or quinoa or buckwheat, and add apples, maybe some nuts, and some cinnamon to them. You can also add apples to all sorts of delicious, juicy, leafy green salads. Apples also go great with cabbage, both green and red cabbage, as part of various raw slaws. Apples are also super versatile to be used as part of all sorts of snacks and treats and desserts. We have to just hopefully keep in mind that we don't want to destroy their precious nutritional and health benefits. And so we want to keep any treats or snacks or desserts that we make with apples in their raw forms. This is where you can make amazing apple ice cream, which you can find me talking about in a previous Healthytarian video. You can also make various cakes and pies based on apples that are fully raw and allow us to enjoy the best of the apple's nutrition and health benefits. And you can also check out a Healthytarian video where I show you how to make a raw apple crumble cake. Of course, if you have a dehydrator, then you can enjoy making all sorts of dehydrated apple goodies. One of the most yummiest ways that we can experience apples is as dehydrated apple chips. And these are super easy to do. Remove the core and thinly slice the apples. Lay them down on dehydrator sheets and dehydrate for at least 24, sometimes up to 48 hours. It will all depend on the environmental conditions and such. But in general, keep in mind to always dehydrate at temperatures below 115 degrees Fahrenheit. Of course, if you do have a dehydrator, you can then make all sorts of other goodies with apples, including amazing apple crepes. These crepes are fully raw and Combine just a few wholesome ingredients like flax seeds, some raisins, and you can make delicious, nutritious crepes that you can feel so good about. If you have a juicer, you can also juice your apples. While we don't want to, as I shared with you earlier, depend on any store-bought pasteurized processed apple juice, we can include apples as part of some wholesome, freshly made home juices. The key and trick here to get the most, again, is to make sure that our juice is mostly always based on vegetables, with just a little addition of apples, if that, not making a high apple juice or a full apple juice, in which case, yes, we will get some benefits, but we're mostly just getting the sugars without the whole package of fibers and other nutrients as well. And so for more tips and ideas here, you can check out another Healthytarian video where I show you how to make a simple green vegetable juice based on kale, celery, and apples. Now, if you're wondering about applesauce, this is a little bit tricky because it all depends on where that applesauce is coming from. Best case scenario would be you making your own applesauce that has come from local organic apples, that is not sweetened, and that was heated at a very, very low temperature. Lowest temperature for the lowest amount of time possible. If we go to any store-bought applesauces, then we have to contend with usually some kind of a sweetener. But even if you find an all-natural, organic, non-sweetened variety, these are typically cooked and heated at industrial levels where they are exposed to high heat for prolonged periods of time. To get the most out of our apples, we want to keep them in the least processed, most wholesome form possible. And so this is just some of the ways that you can incorporate apples. Of course, you may think of so many other wholesome, fresh, raw ways in which you can use your apples in amazing and delicious and creative ways. And so I hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks for joining me, and see you next time.